Our merciful Father, Borei Shamayim Va'aretz, creator of the heavens and the earth, we invoke your name in the presence of all who are gathered here and ask that you give us your blessing. We approach this day, this moment, with a sense of awe and gratitude for the gift of life and the good fortune for having reached this graduation day. We attempt to make it special as we consecrate it with a ritual, a graduation ritual, which helps us to acknowledge the important fact that our graduates and their loved ones have passed through a threshold in time. Today we hope and pray that we do not take this moment for granted, and so we give thanks. We give thanks to our parents for having raised us, taught us values, and sent us to worthy teachers, for having seen us through sickness and crisis, and for schlepping us around until we received our licenses. We thank our teachers, men and women who devote and dedicate themselves to their students, people who ignite the love of learning within their students' hearts and minds. We stand here today with our faith strengthened in the fact that the divine goodness within each of us has been enhanced. We pray that the goodness within each of us transforms our soul and body to change the world which we live in. May our hands, remold some small part of it in your divine image. Cause our feet to lead us to paths of righteousness and caring for those less fortunate. Help our minds to devise new solutions to age-old problems. Let us give thanks to the one who has kept us in life, sustained us, and enabled us to reach this special occasion. As we read in the Psalms, may the Lord our God show us compassion. May he firmly establish the work of our hands, and may the favor of the Lord our God be upon us. Blessed be you in your coming in. Blessed be you in your going out.
At every South Lakes commencement, the Wind Ensemble and Concert Choir have opened the program with America the Beautiful. This 10th performance is surely the best ever. Thank you to the senior members of these two groups. You will surely be missed. Thanks also to Mrs. Ann Stahmer, choral director, and Mr. Jeff Fraker, the band director. We'd also like to thank Rabbi David Ebstein at this time. Good afternoon. It is my pleasure to welcome you to the 10th commencement at South Lakes High School. I would like to welcome our special guests, Mr. Junker and Mrs. Whitney, the administration and faculty of South Lakes High School, our parents, families, and friends, and most importantly, the class of 1990. I would like to thank the class of 90 for your support over the last 4 years. As a class officer, I've worked closely with many of you, and I've observed many changes, as I'm sure you all have. From our freshman year, when we marched into the Green Subschool and had to face the wrath of Mr. Jenkins. Or in 10th grade, when the entire senior class had a sit-in protesting the enforcement of the hat policy by Mr. Jenkins. Today, that man that we thought was such a cruel dictator is our friend, and we fondly call him Frank. We have built homecoming floats and organized class activities. Who remembers Dance Through the Decades? And who can forget Auto Shades? We all remember Adam Long's great idea for Club Coca-Cola. Cool, man, 20-foot video screens. But too bad the truck broke down on the New Jersey Turnpike and we canceled the dance. I think our greatest achievement, however, has been our class motto, so beautifully composed by Sean Joyner. I feel that we should let our parents hear how well we have memorized it. One, two, three. We're the class. You can't say that we haven't learned anything in the last 4 years. In closing, I was looking for something profound to say as we graduate and look toward our future, and it occurred to me that nobody could be more profound than one of my favorite authors, and I'm sure one of yours. Dr. Seuss has this to say about graduation and what may happen in the future in his book, Oh, the Places You'll Go. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the guy who'll decide where to go. He later says, you'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. So be sure when you step, step with care and great tact, and remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98 3/4% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains. So be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai Alley Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. Before we do go move mountains, there are some things the class of 1990 would like to leave behind at South Lakes High School. First of all, we leave our thanks to our teachers. Though we spent this whole year with our senior teachers, we do not forget all of the teachers who have helped us along the way. We may have been too young to thank you before, but we certainly want to recognize you this evening with a big round of applause. And to Frank's next class, the class of 1994, of which my sister Sarah is a member, we leave $100 to help build the freshman float. We have a special thank you tonight. After graduation, we have a whole night of celebrating ahead of us. Tonight, from 12 until tomorrow morning, is the all-night Mardi Gras graduation party. Our parents have been working on this for 12 months. But we would especially like to thank Mrs. Anderson and Mrs. O'Toole. They'd come up here now, please. They have chaired the committee, and we have these gift certificates to the Hunan Lion so you can take your families out to dinner once you get some sleep. They'll get here, don't worry. A lot of people worked hard to make the end of this year go as smoothly as possible. Mrs. Audrey Wild in the main office has helped us manage all of our money. We've become masters at purchase orders. Mrs. Marge Hope has met all of our printing needs, like our next 90 days calendar and the baccalaureate program. We thank as well Mrs. Lynn Ferris for making sure that all the transcripts we requested went to the right place. And the graduation committee, headed by Ian LaValle and Jenise Bordatto, spent long hours preparing for this moment, and we also owe them a round of applause. We'd first like to present our first gifts to the counselors. Mrs. Nelson, Mrs. Ison, and Mrs. Marcus. They've helped us so much throughout the years, especially this year. They've helped us choose classes, changed our schedules countless times, made sure our college applications were completed and mailed in time. We all appreciate your help and dedication. It is my pleasure to present these engraved silver bowls. You guys need to come up here first. I'm not used to this.
You guys are supposed to get those.
Okay, we got these bouquets first of all. I guess you can't
get those. Right there.
These specially signed yearbooks for all of you from the class of 90. And the engraved silver bowls, which... And Adam has those. Guys. Our class would not have been able to be so successful throughout the years if it weren't for our class sponsors. Mrs. LaValle and Mr. Moscone had many obligations. She being a Girl Scout leader and chair of the science department, and he coaching the golf team and the girls' basketball team. However, they always found the time and patience to meet with the officers on a regular basis and give us their support. The class of 1990 would like to present to Mr. Moscone, Vinny, this gift. Mr. Moscone started a game club, and he can often be found playing computer games after he has finished grading physics tests. We hope that this Nintendo Game Boy can bring you happiness as you sit at faculty meetings, mesmerized by whatever game you're playing. One person who's probably the most dedicated to the class of 1990 is Mrs. LaValle. She's been our sponsor for 4 years, working diligently to ensure that the officers always followed through on our tasks. She has attended all of our fundraisers, and her guidance made those fundraisers successful. Without her experience as a class sponsor, we would be lost. It was her idea to construct the senior courtyard, which has gotten a lot of use every sunny day during lunch. In thinking of a gift for Mrs. LaValle, we hit a lot of roadblocks. It is hard to think of something to give to someone who has done so much for us. Mrs. Bilisoly came to the rescue and suggested this present. This is a beautiful watercolor of the senior courtyard, painted by Mrs. Corbett, a local artist and mother of a graduate, Greg Corbett. Mrs. LaValle, remember us fondly. The class of 90 says thank you. We'd also like to present a dozen roses to Mrs. LaValle. In the last 4 years, there has been one person whose patience and love and help we could always count on. She was there every morning when we checked in and there every afternoon when we tried to check out. She waited for us to return from Canada and welcomed us with an unexcused absence. She delivered brownies while we built floats and was always there with her trusty camera documenting our high school life. Mrs. Bilisoly is our mom away from mom. She is graduating today and moving to Wilmington, North Carolina, because she knows that no other class could take the place of the class of 90. In thinking of a gift for her, the first thing that came to mind was an all-expense-paid trip to Canada, but we couldn't afford it. However, you can always come join us at Beach Week. Mrs. Bilisoly published her poem to us on the last page of the senior section of the yearbook, and we have a cross-stitch poem that we would like to present to her. To Mrs. B, our senior mom, what made us friends in the long ago when first we met? Well, we think we know, the best in us and the best in you hailed each other because they knew that always and always since time began, our being friends was part of God's plan. Love, 1990. We also have a yearbook for Mrs. Bilisoly. And this lovely bouquet of flowers. And now, Mr. Jenkins, Frank. What can I say that hasn't already been said? He came to South Lakes the same year we did, and I think he has changed the most out of anyone in the class of 90. Voted most likely to be remembered in the senior superlatives. I don't know how he could be forgotten. He is an honorary member of the Sammy Club, and you can always tell when he is around by the scent of aqua velva. Frank is going back to green next year. Who knows what his new pet peeve will be now that students are allowed to wear hats. But we do know that he will carry with him great memories of the class of 90. That's right, but he'll also be carrying this handcrafted briefcase made of 100% leather. This monogram briefcase has his initials and today's date. And we hope it's something you'll always carry with you. We also have... We also have for Mr. Jenkins this plaque with a hat mounted on it to remind you of the good old days when you used to confiscate hats. We hope you'll keep it in your office as you travel up and down the subschools. Thanks for everything, Mr. Jenkins. We'll miss you. At the beginning of this year, the officer sat down with Mrs. Lavallee and Mr. Moscone, and we made a list of what we had to do this year. One of those things was to leave a class gift. Unfortunately, Mrs. Lavallee rejected my idea of a barbed wire fence around the parking lot so that nobody could leave for lunch next year after we're gone. She came up with a much better idea, however. We contacted Reston Association and several landscape companies, and we drew up a plan for the senior courtyard. When we came to school on the first day of the fourth quarter, the courtyard was waiting for us. We hope that it will continue to be kept up and used for everyone's enjoyment. Dr. Schmelzer, please accept, on behalf of South Lakes High School, the senior courtyard presented by the class of 1990.
All of us, thank you for the beautiful senior courtyard. Each time I see it, memories of the class of 1990 will flash before my eyes. In the fall of 1986, you entered this class from intermediate school, as did Mr. Jenkins. Some of you had energy to burn and were quickly pronounced by your leader as freshman fools. As the time progressed through the sophomore year, the other administrators began to refer to the class of 90 as Frank's fools. Somehow, by your junior year, Mr. Jenkins began to claim each and every one of you and referred to you as my fools. This year, frankly, Mr. Jenkins protected you with such vigor that the administrative staff began to call you Frank's future. He assured us that you never did anything wrong. He'd take care of you. You were perfect. I hope that each of you realize that Mr. Jenkins has your name, address, and exactly where you will be, because for him and for the rest of us, you are our future. You represent the future for your parents, relatives, friends who have stuck with you for these 18 years, through ups and downs, joys and sorrows, and now join you at your graduation. You will remain in the memories of the faculty and staff here at South Lakes. In Stanley Freeman's book about a high school teacher, he talks about small victories in the lives of teachers. A student creates a poem or a painting, wins a contest, sings or plays a difficult work, returns to complete the work after running away, begins to believe in himself or herself, and so on. Each step is a small victory, not only for the student, but for the staff member. Each year, as we watch you grasp your diplomas and move on, each year we return to greet with Mr. Jenkins a new group of fools. In September, they will join us, and in 4 years, like you, become our future. For the hours of dedication, the caring, the knowledge, the moments given beyond the expected, I'd appreciate, as you did once before, if you would join me in applauding the work of this outstanding faculty. Each day as we view the senior courtyard, we will fondly remember the class of 1990. I applaud each and every one of you, and thank you so much for that outstanding gift. At this time, it is my pleasure to present the honor graduates, Mr. Jenkins, your subschool principal, and Coann Whitney, the chairman of the Fairfax County School Board, will join me in presenting the honor graduates. These students have achieved a grade point average of 4.0 or above. In this class, we have 20 such members, which is truly outstanding. That is a straight A or better. If you would please come forward as I read your name to receive your medal, and please remain on stage until all 20 of you are here. Scott Anderson. Jessica Ahrens. Michelle Becker. Stephanie Brooks. Claudia Crosby. Christian DeAndrea. Allison Foreman. Jennifer Grippentrog. Julie Hornan. Kendra Hudson. John Kelly. Adam Long. Gregory Lubanecki. Sean McEwen. Jessica O'Toole. Daniel Peters. Grant Puckett. Emily Rossman. Brooke Spellman. And Elizabeth Stewart. Join me in one more round of applause for these outstanding young people. Truly an impressive group. Thank you. Each year, the faculty nominates young men and women from the graduating class to receive the faculty award. The faculty award is based on leadership, character, responsibility, citizenship, and academic achievement, so that these young people most closely exemplify the standards of excellence to which South Lakes aspires. This nomination is unknown to the students. While we have one winner, we have six strong candidates for the faculty award, and I'd like to call their names and read a little bit about each one before I announce the winner, for indeed, they are each and every one a winner. First of all, Thorea Barnwell. Stand up. Thorea was president of the Alliance for Minority Concerns, co-captain of the track team, recipient of the Girl Scout Gold Award, Girl Scout delegate to Scotland, has sung in the church and school choirs, regional choir, has been a Sunday school teacher, vice president of SAD, and will attend Rutgers University next year. The next nominee is Christian DeAndrea. Christian was the editor-in-chief of the Portfolio, Jefferson Scholar, Governor's School, Eagle Scout, ranked number one in the senior class, varsity soccer, indoor track, Jets winning Jets team, German, math, National Honor Society, and he will attend Harvard next year. Christian. Josh Harwood. Josh was co-captain of the basketball team, his fourth year on the team, all-academic team for the Beach Ball Classic, Presidential Student Athlete Award, AB Honor Roll, has worked in construction for 3 years. He has also been an outstanding aide in the front office. He will attend Virginia Tech next year. Adam Long. Adam has been the class vice president of the senior class, class treasurer of the 11th grade, played football 9 through 12, lettered and was co-captain in his 12th grade year, Latin club, honor society, has worked on the scribe 10 through 12, on the math and national honor societies, volunteered at the Reston Hospital in his 11th and 12th grade years, and he will attend the University of Virginia. Adam. The next candidate, Gregory Lubinecki. Greg served as co-president of the Student Government Association his 12th grade year. He's been in the Math, Latin, and National Honor Societies, president and vice president at grades 11 and 12, has been on the debate and forensics teams, grade 9 through 12. He's worked on the Sentinel staff. He has been a Department of State summer ambassador, part of the National Honor Society, and he will attend MIT next year. Greg. And our sixth candidate, Rebecca, or as we know her, Mikey Sherrill. Co-president of the Student Government Association, grade 12, has worked as a cheerleader for 4 years, been in the wind ensemble and the concert band during her stay at South Lakes, has been on the swim team, has earned academic and music and cheerleading letters, has been a swim teacher and a coach, and she has been appointed and will attend the U.S. Naval Academy next year. I'd like to ask Mr. Junker, who is the Assistant Superintendent for Financial Services, to help me in making this award. The 1990 Faculty Award goes to Greg Lubinecki. If you'll please come forward.
first of our two songs today is Out Here on My Own from the movie Fame. We dedicate this song today to our parents because they have prepared us to be out on our own, but we know that they will always be there if we need them.
Sometimes I wonder where I've been, who I am, do I fit in, make believe in, it's hard alone, out here on my own. And shine me home out here on my own. Bye.
We'd now like to introduce our guest speaker. Mrs. Hill attended Wesley College in Wesley, Massachusetts, and graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Mathematics in 1969. She attended the University of Chicago Graduate School and the Graduate School of Education. In 1972, received a Master's of Arts in Teaching Mathematics. From 1971 until 1974, she taught in succession high school, junior college, and college mathematics. Mrs. Hill was a scientist with a private consulting firm in the Washington, D.C. area. From 1978 until 1981, she was the special assistant to the Secretary of the Army. Mrs. Hill is now Vice President of Alexander & Associates Incorporated, a corporate consulting firm in Washington, D.C. But the reason we invite her to join us today is that she's the co-president of our PTSA and the mother of a graduating senior. It is my pleasure to present Mrs. Janet Hill.
Dr. Schmelzer, distinguished platform guests, parents, relatives, and friends, I join each of you in saluting this class of 1990 on the occasion of their graduation from high school. Indeed, it is no small accomplishment to have come this far in the short period of 18 years. I also bring you greetings from Rob Robinson and the distinguished members of the class of 1989. Actually, when he heard that I was going to address you, Rob's exact words were, "Now I know I'll be mentioned." In preparing my remarks today, I was offered a lot of unsolicited advice from my family. My son had four suggestions: be inspiring, be funny, be brief, and don't embarrass me. Okay, Grant, I'll try to do that. My husband suggested I prepare any humorous remarks I intend to make because, as he puts it, even though I'm black, I'm not spontaneously funny. I know that 99% of all the students graduating this year will not recall what the speaker said. And I know that 20 minutes after the ceremony is over, you won't even remember who the speaker was. So I'm going to take advantage of these brief moments when I have your undivided attention and you remember my name. To paraphrase an old saying, tomorrow begins the rest of your life after South Lakes High School. You are the generation who is moving into adulthood at a time when peace is breaking out throughout the world and people are fighting for personal freedoms that we take for granted. At the same time, you have grown up during the 80s, which have been acknowledged as a very turbulent period. There have been many changes that took place in this country during that time, not all of them good. We, your parents, are mostly products of the 60s, another extremely turbulent period that was characterized by deep emotion about human rights, freedom, and the battle for democracy abroad. During that time, the upheavals, protests, and social changes, as well as the deaths of the prominent and the anonymous, shaped forever our attitudes, values, and principles. Curiously and inexplicably, this period may have fostered the several characteristics that defined the 80s: greed, manipulation, selfishness, renewed bigotry, and a general intolerance of others. As a nation, we have almost stopped caring for those most in need. More people are homeless. Government-backed student loans have been cut, denying a college education to more students. The poor amongst us are routinely denied basic needs, and dependency on controlled substances has escalated. In my estimation, however, the most disturbing development of the last 10 years has been our incapacity to accept, defend, and even cherish our differences as a people. Instead, during the past decade, it became permissible, even fashionable, to wear our prejudices quite openly, to publicly declare our intolerance, even hatred, of others because of their sex, race, color, national origin, religion, sexual preference, or economic status. The result has been a polarization of groups, an escalation of tensions, fears, and negative perceptions, all of which has caused a diminishing of the quality of our collective lives. My expectations of you are greater than this. You have benefited already from being nurtured in the environment of South Lakes High School and Reston, both of which have escaped much of the bitterness and hatred already described. As you move ahead into the 90s, you should extend yourselves to those who need your help, advice, support, and encouragement. This doesn't necessarily require an expenditure of money, but it does require the commitment of your time and attention to others. To fail to do so perpetuates the unraveling of the quality of our collective lives. The greatest sense of personal gratification is not in how much money you make or how powerful you are, but how much you make a positive difference in the life of someone other than yourself. If you're going on to college, you can look forward to new academic and social challenges. I advise those of you who are greasy grinds or nerds to loosen up a little bit and seek a balanced life during your college career. I was a nerd once. Okay, Grant, I know I still am. And I know it was a mistake to fail to take full advantage of the social interrelationships that are an important part of the college experience. Those of you who are college bound but already more social than you need to be, watch out. The academic challenges awaiting you are several notches more demanding than high school, and your opportunity to fail is always as close as one more party or several more hours of goofing off. Some of you will join most of us adults in the work world very soon. Well, welcome to the rest of your life. All of you should remember that most able-bodied adults spend considerable time working. Hopefully, your work experience will be fruitful and satisfying, but I do offer you one piece of advice. If you find your job is impossible, either because you can't do the work or you don't like the work, then look for other opportunities. It is a sign of maturity to know what you can't do or what is not suited for you, and to seek other work experiences that will allow you to be productive. I am sure a few of you in this class are neither going to college nor have a job lined up. In fact, you don't know what you will be doing with yourselves, and some of you don't care. Well, I have been authorized by your parents to tell you that you have until 5 p.m. tomorrow to make up your minds. None of you should have the luxury of remaining persistently idle and gainfully unemployed with no visible means of support. To do nothing with your lives for extended periods of time and live more or less as a sponge off your family is a signal of advanced immaturity. To quote Shakespeare, "You are only young once, but you can remain immature forever." To my fellow parents, I extend my congratulations on this occasion. We all know graduations and the ceremony surrounding them are for us, a sort of validation of our efforts to bring our children to the threshold of adulthood. Nothing we do in our everyday work world is more important, rewarding, and difficult than raising our children. Your child has charmed you, cajoled you, impressed, infuriated, and exhausted you. But he or she needed you to get to this point today. The South Lakes faculty, administration, and staff have put up with a lot from this class of 1990. In the pursuit of teaching this class the basics and much, much more, you have been consistently excellent and hardworking. In addition, you have been tolerant, generally good-humored, tough when you need to be, and compassionate when appropriate. In return, the class has been a little bit of everything: charming, quaint, comic,
diligently hardworking, lazy, and sometimes quite literally absurd. Undeniably, the class and each of its members has been broadened and enriched by your efforts. To those of you who are underclassmen at South Lakes, you have giant shoes to fill in following this class. I know you look up to them as being savvy, smart, with it, and accomplished. Well, this is part true and part myth. To underclassmen, seniors do seem to know exactly what to do and when to do it, or conversely, what to avoid doing and how to avoid being caught. But magically, mystically, and without even feeling it, you too will be enabled with the same powers by the time you have reached the advanced stage of being a senior. The best description of this phenomenon was expressed by the class speaker at the very first South Lakes graduation in 1981. He said, "Freshmen don't know, but they don't know that they don't know. Sophomores don't know, but they know that they don't know. Juniors know, but they don't know that they know. But seniors know, and they know that they know." Well, this is it, graduates. It's time to move ahead to the rest of the ceremony and the conferring of your diplomas. The educational level you have now attained cannot be stripped from you by others. Only you can fail to use it to advance morally, physically, intellectually, and practically as an adult. From now on, your lives will be characterized by many decisions and choices. Decision-making is often difficult and complicated, but always inescapable. You may be free to say yes or no, but you are not free to avoid saying one or the other. Living is serious business, and the thing that makes it serious are the choices you face. But the secret of successful living is not making the right decision every time decision is required. Those who manage life successfully are those who make the best of both the good and the bad. They are winners even when they lose. I congratulate you again and wish each of you the best in your lifetime endeavors.
It's a great honor and privilege for me to be able to introduce the first of our two student speakers today. Christian D'Andrea came to South Lakes in 10th grade after 16 years in Minneapolis. But even though he's been here for only 3 years, he has made an everlasting impression on his peers and faculty alike. When you first meet someone like this, you get the feeling that he's probably just a bookworm or a compulsive studier. Yet this year I've really gotten to know Christian and was surprised by his social antics. Nothing bad, of course. Before I let Christian take the microphone, there's one thing left I have to say. Not only is Christian a good friend of mine and a respected student among the faculty, but he's also number one ranked in our class, and he'll be going to some school called Harvard this fall. Anyway, without further delay, let me present Mr. Christian D'Andrea.
Dr. Schmelzer, honored guests, faculty, friends and relatives, and South Lake class of 1990. While preparing this speech over the past couple of days, I've returned a number of times to an image. I see myself paddling a canoe on a lake rimmed by forest. The woods are beautiful. There's nobody within my... unusual. Big, green, purring tubes hang from the ceilings. That's unusual. The different grade levels are color-coded. The creations of the arts department come at you from all sides and all colors in certain halls. And now the red metal angles of John Parker grace the entrance to the school. That's unusual. The people are surprising, too. The round-the-clock dedication of the faculty keeps the school running smoothly. Their challenges surprise us, and we students surprise right back with the infinite variety of our responses to those challenges. Our teachers love their fields and share their wealth in unique ways. Certain members of our class were born with a wheeler-dealer instinct and an economic savvy that have enabled them to fill their hefty wallets with wads of dough. We have students who can, of an afternoon, come up with inspired melodies and lyrics celebrating the intricate community of nature. Some of our colleagues can multiply big numbers really quickly. Others can write passages that don't just impress with their complexity, but actually get at the heart of a story or a person. We have athletes who run like the wind and play like a jazz riff. Some of them speak foreign languages, intelligibly. Others talk ferociously on any topic, at any time, at any length, and consider very little to be sacred. This is a real community. This is the water underneath the canoe. It's the pool of talent and potential and diversity that comes from having all varieties of people taught and inspired by eager teachers, raised by parents who love them, and stimulated by each other. The underlying community supports each of us, as water does a boat. I think that's why the image of the boat kept recurring to me. No matter which way you spin or dart or dip, the water is always there, ready to support you and ready to carry you forward. The water makes me reflective. It makes me think about canoeing further. I think we can expand our community to Africa, the Middle East, Latin America, Eastern Europe, and the Pacific Rim. Our schooling has made us aware of the world around us. We know of the mammoth dimensions of the problems facing the world. Someone should focus on the mammoth dimensions of the solution in this room. Pick the most fantastic, amazing, ambitious task imaginable and do it. We here, graduating today, are part of a potent, compact force that will solve the world's problems. So although limited in vision, our hobo friend that I imagined earlier does have something I want. I'd like to be a hobo. I've always had an affinity for Huckleberry Finn types. He sees America drift by as sun set and orange takes over the horizon and profound dogs howl in the distance. That's living. If you were to take what you see, a beautiful country, and involve yourself not just in the use of it, but in the support of it, and even better, in the molding of it, you would have true experience, real first-rate prime life. Take the hobo and develop him. In the improvement of this conceptual hobo canoeist are the successors to Jack Kennedy, Shakespeare, Marie Curie, and even Michael Jordan, Michael. Give it a try. Give it a try. You can't sink with a pool of clear water like us supporting you. Good luck, good luck, good luck. Thank you very much.
It is my honor to introduce one of the most intellectual and caring individuals I know, who also happens to be my favorite English teacher. She attended Pepperdine University, where she majored in English and social studies. Later, she began her master's study at the University of Virginia, but received her master's degree from Virginia Tech. She then began her teaching career, where she taught in such places as Pakistan and Bangkok, and later Fauquier County, before coming to South Lakes High School. She's been teaching for 23 years. 7 of those years have been spent here at South Lakes High School and the Orange Subschool. Unfortunately, for all those up-and-coming high school students, she's retiring this year, packing up her favorite works of Virginia Woolf and setting out on a trip around the world. After her trip, she plans to study classical Greek and maybe writing a collection of short stories. However, the students that have had her will appreciate the knowledge she passed on to them. So please welcome Ms. Nancy Nurup.
Thank you, Ian. To the class of 1990, Dr. Schmelzer, Mr. Jenkins, parents and guests, to you in this wonderful class, I want to say thanks for allowing me to say a few words to you before you leave South Lakes. I am very honored. Perhaps what I am about to say will surprise those of you who know me. I do know many of you from your sophomore days as well as this year, but my remarks are sincerely meant for each of you here tonight. I want to talk to you about happiness and the pursuit thereof. I do not mean the happiness or joy of being out of high school and into summer vacation, although I think this is important to all of us. But I do mean the serious pursuit of a life that will bring you fulfillment. For if, as Aristotle says, and here I apologize to all of those who may have heard all of Aristotle you ever want to hear, that life, even in its utmost splendor, hangs at the edge of a precipice, then each day must be precious and worthwhile. This does not mean that we cannot enjoy ourselves, that we cannot, as Joseph Campbell says, follow our bliss. If we can't have it all, we can have a good share of it. Let me shift now from us to you, for it is to you that I speak tonight. You have heard often through these past few years of how self-centered you are, that your interests are material, not humanitarian, that you are, if not completely, at least you are at the tail end of the me generation. I and others who have worked with you these past years do not see you that way at all. Of course you want material objects. We all do. But you have participated in food drives, in Earth Day projects, and many of you contribute hours doing community service of one kind or another. There is no reason why these materialistic and humanitarian goals cannot be compatible in your lives. What would be wrong and harmful to you and to the world would be for you to forsake the latter for the former. And this brings me to another point. How do you achieve happiness without it seeming to be a selfish endeavor? I believe that you accomplish this by setting goals that are compatible to your own precepts. You cannot be happy doing what others want or expect you to do unless you want the same things. A few years ago, when our younger son was graduating from high school, he and his friends would sit around and discuss the colleges and universities they were going to attend and what they would be doing after that was completed. They ran the gamut, as one would expect, from the lawyer to the young woman bent on becoming a stage set director. But two of his friends chose not to go to school at all. One of them was an artist with wood. He was a beautiful carpenter, and he chose to apprentice to become a cabinet maker. The second young man loved tinkering with cars. He chose to become a skilled mechanic, specializing in the maintenance of foreign-built autos. Now, 7 years later, the auto expert has settled into a satisfying and rewarding profession. The craftsman teaches his art while building a house for his parents in the foothills of the Shenandoahs. Both of them are happily living their dream occupations. They did not follow the expected path. They followed their own sense of what was right for them. You must be true to your own precepts. But that does not mean that once having chosen a goal, you can never change it. For that is my next point. You must allow yourselves to be open to the world of ideas and to the possibility of change. I call this aspect in life the serendipity of life. Library shelves and bookstores are crowded with books that tell of lives unfulfilled, dreams unrealized, men and women looking back on lives that did not come up to their expectations, lives filled with the might have beens. Many of you are already certain what you want to do with your lives. You may have a career mapped out, a goal set, and plans for how to achieve it. Others of you are still thinking and weighing possibilities, perhaps hoping something will just click and set you on your course. Whichever category you are in, do not discount the serendipitous moment that may present itself. An opportunity to try the unexpected, to explore the uncharted map, to hear a different drummer. But remember, it isn't easy being green. Whatever you do, I hope that life will be good to you, as it has been to me, and that you will continue to give to others the satisfaction, the joy that you have given me. I want to close with a toast, a dry one, to be sure, This comes from the only novel that Carl Sandburg ever wrote, Remembrance Rock, and was given to me on my high school graduation. The toast is this. Here's to the storms and to the stars that come after. May your own lives be filled with stars. Thank you. And good night.
It was a great challenge trying to figure out what to say in this interaction. Our next speaker is a name well known around the school and especially throughout our class. The person to whom I'm referring is not your normal, everyday high school senior. He's a little different. But it's old to say that he's different because everyone is so used to his ways that his different has become normal. One word that enters most people's minds when thinking of him is unique. Most of you know him from his non-conformed and sometimes eccentric appearance. To say the least, he is an individualist. From the time he entered Langston Hughes' doors to Southlake's 1990 prom, to the time he crosses the stage this evening, he's paved his own path, set his own standards, and dared to be the leader, not the follower. Primarily, he's known as the class clown, but when it comes down to it, he is an intellectual. One moment he'll make you laugh with all his jokes, and next he'll amaze you with his knowledge. The person of whom I'm speaking is none other than Thambistus.
Thank you. It's been fun. The 4 years are past. There are no more bells to ring out for class. The halls are empty, yet full of delight, because the class of 90 walks the stage tonight. Math and government, we've passed their hardest tests. We've left them behind and proved we're the best. So I'd like to say some words which will not please. Never mind, I'd get in trouble for these. But one thing's for sure, we're out of this place, which causes this smile plastered on my face. Though we'll miss Kay and Francis quite a bit, we now have the rest of our lives to try all kinds of stuff. Some teachers were wrong and caused us much stress, but now I don't mind because I'm wearing this dress. It's a crazy thought, no one can deny, that a man in a dress can be the apple of a crowd's eye. And whether college or work is what you seek, I'm a man in a dress who you're watching speak. At this South Lakes fiesta, the closing song is the key for the HE boys to burrow, jocks and cheerleaders to leave. Some will hop and skip or laugh or cry, but Michelle and Margaret are the apple of my eye. For we all have those whom we love with all our heart, and they will now cry because it's our time to depart. But we will all leave smiling with one thing on our minds. The class of 90 is spray painted on all of Reston's road signs. With graduation, new futures begin. Our minds expand and new goals click in. We will change the world, a few of us at least, because life is a bowl of cherries upon which we are here to feast. All sarcasm aside, Mr. Hunsberger's helped us the most because he's given us more parking tickets than anyone can boast. So as we walk across this graduation stage tonight, do not do it with any degree of fright because we are here to be gay, out of control in a happy way. But do not go to the worst extremes. Don't drink and drive. It will kill all dreams. Somewhere around now, I run out of time, so like all great things, I must end my rhyme. I will do so with this class favorite, which is super chronic on the goobometer, as I'm hanging brain. Everybody join in. You know it. Brian said it. We're the class of 90. Yes, sirree. We're the class of 90. You and me.
Our next speaker is one of my favorite teachers and has been a great inspiration to me during this past year. Those students who have been privileged to have experienced this class will agree with me that his retirement this year will be an irreplaceable loss to South Lakes High School. His reputation will live on as a unique man with an entertaining teaching style. To get his point across, he has been known to hurdle chairs, remove articles of clothing, burst out into song, or scream in aggravation and concern about the political scene. Mr. Tripp graduated from the University of California at Berkeley in 1955, where he received his bachelor's and master's in the political science. He has been a teacher for 30 years and taught in New York State, Liverpool, England, Yellow Springs, Ohio, Detroit, Michigan, as well as South Lakes High School. His credentials and past achievements, however, are not as important as the mark he has left on his students. It is a personal honor for me to introduce someone so special to me, Mr. Robert Tripp.
That's what I was going to say to you. Hang on. I'm the last one, I think. Thank you for the honor of asking me to speak at your graduation. And congratulations to all of you for having made it here today. It may have been easier for some of you than others, but the important thing is that you did make it. And think of this. It took you 4 years to graduate high school. It's taken me 30, but I'm finally out of here. This has been a remarkable year. From my students, I learned to use terms I hadn't used before. And the year saw the invention of a word new to everyone, so far as I know. The first time that David Lewis said to me, "Hey, dude," I have to admit, I was a bit startled. But after a while, I grew to like the word, and I actually started using it. "Hey, dude." And I loved it when Jeff Blondin said to me when I was in one of my periodical fits, "Hey, Mr. Tripp, chill out." Neat phrase. I like that. But the word that has become the symbol of much of what I believe is the one that Melanie Kamerling and I accidentally invented during a class discussion one day, oath hour. And so my main message to you today is beware of the dangers of oath hour. Why should authority and power, oath hour, be dangers to be aware of? Because, my good friends, I have become convinced after the study of human history and my own experience of nearly six decades on this planet that Lord Acton was right. Power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. And the only way I know of keeping power from becoming corrupt in a democratic society is for the citizens, you and me, to keep authority, those who exercise power, from becoming too comfortable. We must always, you know what I'm going to say, question, challenge, make authority accountable. It is simply too easy. It is simply too easy for authority to bamboozle and fool people with smooth talk and clever TV ads with statements such as, "We really know what's best for you," etc. Baloney, balderdash. If we let authority hand us this line, we become victims of oath hour, we betray the essence of what this great land of ours is all about, and we show we're stupid besides. So why am I telling you this now? Because to remind you, your childhood is over. You are adults now. And to my profound hope is that your generation will do a better job than my generation did of keeping oath hour in check. And I'm not just talking about political oath hour, you know, our elected leaders, them too. I'm also talking about oath hour in organizations, bureaucrats, administrators, yes, even teachers. Keeping oath hour in check won't be easy. Oath hour tends to resist being challenged and is good at it. So if you want to check oath hour, you must be effective. This means that when you question and challenge, you must do so intelligently. Wild, angry, frustrated screaming at oath hour, while it may feel good at the moment, will not work. What made Martin Luther King and the other civil rights leaders successful, and they were successful in ending legal segregation in this country, was that their challenging of oath power was effective. They knew how to use their brains as well as their bodies to challenge the system, to challenge oath power. You and I must do no less. The great issues of our time that I, as well as others, have talked about before still cry out for resolution. Though legal segregation is dead, racism is still with us, if sometimes a bit more subtle. Sexism is still with us, not often very subtle. Religious, ethnic, and sexual discrimination are still with us. We are still allowing the earth to be environmentally raped. We still have too many poor and homeless people in this very rich land. There are still attacks on our civil liberties by those who are afraid of freedom. We must still work hard to prevent our technological marvels from engulfing us. And within your senior year of high school, we have seen wonderful new challenges open up in the incredible changes in Eastern Europe, the Soviet Union, and South Africa. It is our job to see to it that oath hour acts wisely and honestly in these and other areas. A major value of school surely is to help students develop their ability to act intelligently and wisely, and indeed to want to act so, to want to get involved. It is important to be aware of oath hour's dangers, but it is also important to be intelligent about it, to have knowledge and skills. Thus, I would slightly alter the expression just say no, N-O, to just say no, K-N-O-W. If we teachers have helped you see the importance both of having knowledge and of using it wisely, then we've done a good job. But we should also have helped you see that knowledge and wisdom, to be fully effective, have another dimension, another side, an ethical and a moral one. This is tricky, for definitions of morality are not easily agreed upon. For me, the issue is basically simple. I take it as a given that we all need each other on this planet, and that my fate and yours are tied together. Thus, my effort is to try to direct what knowledge and wisdom I may have toward helping my fellow human beings, as well as helping myself. Sometimes this, too, is not easy, as we get caught up in our daily lives and in the race to be a success, whether financial or otherwise. But you'll find, I think, that your knowledge and wisdom will be best for you when you also consider that you can help other people, who in turn then can help you. In other words, folks, please care about each other. We all really do need one another. We need to challenge actions, but we must also have some compassion for the actor. We can disagree and still care about each other. This reminds me of a passage from one of my favorite books, L. Frank Baum's The Wizard of Oz. I like the passage because it reflects a combination of awareness and challenging of oath hour, and also compassion for others. When Dorothy finds out that the wizard is a fake, you may recall, she's very angry, and she tells the wizard, "You're a very bad man." Do you remember the wizard's reply? He said, "No, my dear, I'm a very good man. I'm a very bad wizard." There's a message there, gang. The distinction is important. I leave you with a confession. I have had 3 love affairs in my life. See? A doubter already. You should live so long. Bet you didn't think that a funny old duffer like me could have love affairs, did you? But I have, and what's more, they're still going on. Yep. My first and foremost love affair is with my wonderful wife of 34 years. My second is with my own children, who I think are great. But my third love affair is with you, my students. Do you really know how wonderful you are? What has made me being an educator all these years worthwhile is students such as you. I don't understand why teachers who don't love people, young people, stay in teaching. Perhaps they love oath hour more. Anyway, thank you. You, the South Lakes class of 1990, have been especially wonderful. You have made my last year of playing the game of school so very marvelous and rewarding. Part of my love affair with you is believing that you will go out to this world tough and strong and get involved and make a difference, do it. With that, what more can an old teacher ask? Bless you. I love you. Thank you.
Thank you to all our speakers tonight. Our second song this evening is Tomorrow, A Better You, A Better Me. This song is dedicated to the class of 1990 in the hope that tomorrow will be the best for all of us.
Try, we can fly to a whole other place. Oh, we- Thank you. For those of you who are not aware, that portion of the graduation ceremony that you just saw will be on 7 on your side tomorrow. So the cameras are here. That will be on television tomorrow. So congratulations to the class of 1990, the first class that actually will be on television. As we remove the beach ball, we'll start. Thank you. I'm going to keep it short tonight because I realize you're eager to receive your diplomas that you worked so hard for. I know this class is extremely eager to get on with their lives. You're eager to join your family and friends at the conclusion of the ceremony. And this is the way it should be. Graduation is far from the end. It's the beginning of your tomorrows. Over the past 4 years, you have worked and studied, practiced, played, and grown mentally as well as physically. And now you are here, ready to begin your lives as members of the adult community. For some of you, it will mean a job and responsibilities in the family life. For others, it will mean college and further years of study and preparation. Whatever course your future takes, it is my sincere hope that you will look back on the 4 years at South Lakes as having prepared you to meet and deal with the challenges that life will present. On behalf of myself, the faculty and staff of South Lakes High School, I wish each one of you happiness of a productive life, the respect of your fellow human beings, and a love of your family. May the future be yours. Best of luck and congratulations to the class of 1990. This is truly a class for class. I'd like to thank all of you for the memories. Now, I, Frank Jenkins, senior sub-school principal, hereby certify that these students before you have met the graduation requirements of the state of Virginia, Fairfax County Public Schools, and South Lakes High School. Therefore, I present to you Dr. Schmelzer, Mrs. Coann Whitney, and Mr. Junker, as well as other members of the faculty, the class of 1990.
Eleanor K. Antis. Felicia Banks. Thorea Sheree Barnwell.
Donna Michelle Alexander. Lori Jo Alexander. Jennifer Lee Alter. Kimberly J. Anderson. Jessica Rachel Ahrens. Chantel Renee Ball. Maisie Jo Barkas. Isabel Christina Bardwell Jones. David Alexander. Mir Ali. Scott Anderson. Kofi Asafu Ajay. Christopher Aldo Bagnulo. Rasan Bailey. Mark Bard. Michael Lee Beal. Ian James Burgle. Tracy Christian Barrett. Catherine Elizabeth Bayes. Alexandra Elizabeth Barrett. Shanae Yvette Barron. Don Raquel Bartholomew. Kelly Ann Beard. Michelle Karen Baker. Catherine Lynn Beers. Lisa Ann Bilfus. Melissa Eleanor Bell. Nikki Binikoff. Carter Williams Blitch. Jeff Blondin. David Paul Bobzine. Arnie Botker. Richard Andrew Bottomley. Thomas Snowden Bourne. Corey Allen Bowden. Daniel Justin Braun. Lyric Michelle Bigelow. Sarah Louise Biddle. Kristen Smith Bittaker. Kim Blackwell. Marcy Yvette Bowden. Corinne Bonacorso. Gloria Ann Booth. Cynthia Jane Borsey. Catherine Lee Bauer. Milena Breezeboy. Ariane Diana Bromfield. Paul Braun. Chad Brown. Julian Robert Bullock. Miguel Burgos. Bradley Joseph Bussey. Lawrence David Bussey. Christopher John Carpenter. William Hunter Catterson. Dacom Shantavasuk. Michelle Desiree Brown. Stephanie Ann Brooks. Jennifer Christine Brunger. Amy Jennifer Busa. Ellen Frances Butler. Blanca Luz Carenza.
Evelyn Chavarria. Shu Fin Chu. Sarah Margaret Chenis. Warren H. Christian III. Broderick Clark. Matthew Charles Cohen. Jeffrey Arthur Corner. Edward Cook. Greg Corbett. Brian Patrick Dedant. Stephen Christopher Davila. Ronnie James Davis. Amy Elizabeth Colliday. Gali Dadoon. Anne Lee Cochran. Candace Cook. Laura Costa. Wendy Elizabeth Crane. Tia Novella Marie Crawford. Claudia Pierke Crosby. Amy Michelle Cummings. Andrea Danzer. Kevin Michael Day. Alan Frederick Steele. Jason Patrick Devine. Douglas Dobrinsky. Sapik Dok. Eric Jonathan Dupre. Hallie Driscoll Dunn. James Whitney Dunn. Joseph Raymond Dunn. Elizabeth Duncan. Rocio De Leon. Kelly Nicole Dean. Michelle Catherine De La Pena. Kimberly Ann Denninger. Danielle Yvonne DeYoung. Angela K. DeWall. Loretta Janae Dixon. Erin Lorraine Dobbs. Tara Christina Engelhart. Erin Eileen Epler. David Dye. Mark Edwards. Matthew McKee Ekstrom. Matthew George Herbert Endicott. Mark Andres Farnsworth. Matthew Joseph W. Fay. Eric Scott Sellers. Brian Edward Field. James Underwood Fisher. Allison Rachel Foreman. Kimberly Ann Robin Finkelman. Jenny Mae Fletcher. Heather Lynn Flood. Malia Christine Flynn. Kelly Christine Ford. Catherine Ann Free. Joanne Marie Free. Karen Michelle Fry. Brooke Lee Garceau. Enrique Alexander Flood. Nicholas Emery Owen Gaglio. Brian Delano Gert. Anthony Gibson. John Gillum. David Gilligan. Robert Bradley Gibbon. Stephen Leonard Gohn. Dennis Reynolds Freeman.
Maja Talal Gama. Kimberly Kathleen Gordon. Patricia Pontip Gorgon. Heather Lee Grant. Jennifer Ann Gray. Lisa Marie Griffith. Jennifer Jo Grippentrog. Jenny Groff. Vabuti Gupta. Alexis Kim Hall. Jennifer Lynn Hample. Scott Edward Gordon. Robert Sean Gore. Gary Nicholas Granger. David Gray. Matthew Holden Gray. Jonathan Scott Green. Ryan Grizzard. Alan Scott Goldstein. William Herbert Gray IV. Tracy Lynn Hoffman. Gwendolyn Rosanna Harris. Elizabeth Ann Heckman. Alexandra Beth Heller. Alejandra Raquel Hernandez. Linda Renee Hicks. Shanae Susan Hirsch. Julie Kathleen Hornig. Kendra Ann Hudson. Elizabeth Dorothy Hummel. Lippy High. James Rankine Harding. Luke Dominic Harris Evans. Vance Alexander Hartke. Josh Campo Harwood. Clay Hatcher. Paul Christian Hawkins. Colin R. Heichman. Donovan Herbig. William M. Hewlett III. Melanie Joy Kamerling. Suzanne Inek. Amberlyn Catherine Ireland. Adrian Van Marder Jacobson. Ethel Davida Jeffrey. Marissa Jobeck. Vanessa Rachel Johnson. Jones. Jill Elaine Jones. Molly Ann Jones. Rachel Isabel Jones. Todd William Hickman. Dane Victor Hill. Grant Henry Hill. David Luther Hogan. Brandon Christopher Hoyback. Michael Patrick Huck. Jeffrey Hughes. Sajil Hussein. Muhammad Iqbal. Liza Diane Carvelis. Tara Lee Kent. Alex. Allison Kiernan. Julie Michelle Conoco. Amarina Kurtz. Elizabeth Lambert. Elizabeth Leary. Mark A. Isquip. Eric Jacob. Jenise. Scott Jones. Stephen William Jones. Sean Joyner. Omar Sharif Kalali. Brian Patrick Kelly.
Bridget Colleen Lynch. No, Lori. Lori Ann Lefkowitz. Jennifer Michelle Leonard. Deborah Labardi. Michelle Elise Lipson. Christine Patricia Lodge. Stephanie Elise Lombardo. Tiffany Ariane Love. Nicole Lowen. Josie Marie Lupien. Scott Kelly. Patrick Kennedy. Vanerie Teofanbua. William Edward King. Michael John Kozinev. Joshua Krasnogor. Richard Lasker. Chris Lennart. John Lawrence Kelly. Richard Lennon. David Ray Lewis. Christopher Allen Lindsay. Gregory Michael Lubinecki. Danny McGee. Jason Mandel. Marion Lamont Manigault. Thomas Raymond Markison Jr. Jessica Elizabeth Mallett. Candace Marie Malone. Kristen Dorn Marshall. Laura Marie Martin. Karen Ann Massey. Lynn Marie McKeever. Amanda Susan McKinley. Susan Eric Medville. Nicolette Mejia. Lisa McLaughlin Weibel. Chris Moshby. Trevor White McClanahan. Sean Michael McEwen. Anthony McNair. James Ralph McNair. David Melman. Jason Milan Menard. Gregory Llewellyn Mia. Cam Maselli. Karen Jean Messick. Stacy Liel Michaela. Jennifer Drame Mitchell Pan. Piper Lee Moore. Sharon Morgan. Nicole Lee Moser. Natasha Cherie Mullings. Tracy Renee Nichol. Sherilyn Nichols. Dana Jo Nicholson. Sonia Neiman. Jeffrey Joseph Mitra. Joshua Miller. Lawrence Wade Miller. John Joseph Mitchell. John Gurdon Moore. Galvin Darnell Morris. Timothy Robert Morris. Shananik Saad. Jessica Lynn O'Toole. Michelle Karen Papendick. Unyung Amy Park. Janae Mary Parker. Karen Parker. Katrina Parker. Joanne Margaret Parsley. Jessica Aaron Paul. Jennifer Susan Peshaw. Stephanie Lynn Pearson. James Nabi Nabti. Brian Vincent Neal. Jeff Nelson. Timothy Nixon. James David Knoll. Jimmy Capson. Ross Emerson Park. Hoi Le Pham. Nilsa Milagro Perez. Noemi Tui Perez. Mary Nicole Femister. Stephanie Pierce. Shannon Laura Pinkman. Dara Marie Presti. Suzanne Virginia Pruis. Angela Annette Quarles. Lisa Jo Pippin. Lorraine Daniels Plord. Julie Marie Presley. Robert Michael Phillips. Brian Scott Prosser. Robert Parker. Daniel Michael Peters. Alexander Phillips II. Fung A. Nok. Ernie Lee Porter. John Charles Presser. Asinta Vanessa Quesada. Mira Qureshi. Suzette Nicole Ramjatasingh. Renita Ruth Rao. Melanie Mary Reed. Suzanne Lee Richardson. Jennifer Ann Roberts. Laura Robinson. Therese Ann Rogers. Amy Lynn Rarden. Anne Marie Ringe. Lindell A. Prosper. Brent Stewart Puckett. Jason J. Radley. Jonah Rainey. Timothy H. F. Rapp. Justin D. Rash. Damrandeth Ratana. Mario Andretti Ritchie. Valerie Alexandra Rome. Rachel Elizabeth Root. Emily Rebecca Rossman. Susanna Lise Ruff. Kelly Ann Ryan. Michelle Savadani. Christy Ann Sander. Hannah Ellen Schuster. Laura Cecilia Rudder. Sarah Schwartz. Benjamin Lee Rosenquist. Matthew Lee Rosner. Andrew Lee Rudd. Matthew Scott Russell. Karash Sabah. Thurston Samuel. Jeffrey Weldon Sass. David C. Scassa. Dana Schlafman. Kristen Lorraine Schwartzman. Stephanie Janelle Scott. Virginia Ann Shank. Marilyn Shay. Joanna Sherman. Jennifer Lynn Snyder. Jessica Saldo. Jane Tiffany Spear. Rebecca Michelle Sherrill. Rebecca Sarah Smith. Frank Schneider. Joshua Seeley. Severin Sievertson. John Frederick Schaefer. Matthew A. Singer. Vic Citiso. Matthew David Slotsky. Adam Christopher Smith. Reed Lawrence Smith. Terry Ann Stanhope. Kathleen Ann Starman. Catherine Adelaide Stevens. Elizabeth Ann Stewart. Heather Lee Sumner. Allison Lynn Sutherland. Nicole Catherine Swan. Lauren Lynn Tatum. Brooke Patience Spellman. Stephanie Michelle Steger. Diane Sullivan. Dominic Smythe. Jason Brett Sabecki. Gregory Gardner Springsteen. Scott Strickland. Christopher Samuel Strokes. Gregory Thomas Stryker. Matthew Eric Suazo. Tiffany Shane Taylor. Sharon Maria Thompson. Dafia Lasonia Tubman. Elizabeth Diane Turco. Natalie Vanderstur. Marika Van Pembroke. Kristen Marie Vandenberg. Amy Elizabeth Vest. Carly Nicole Bologna. Pankaj Bonsavat. Erica Ann Ulrich. Adam Torman. Bradley Ryan Toth. Scott Chapin Prescott. David William Turk. Joseph Leo Vopalak. Darren Waldron. Andrew Stephen Ward. Michael Ward. Catherine Emily Wagner. Kristen Ann Walker. Teresa Gail Waller. Christy Lynn Walsh. Holly Ann Webb. Kristen Dara Ween. Kimberly May Welch. Jennifer Ann Williams. Lori G. Williams. Donna J. Winarski. Sharon Lee Wiseman. Stephen Sean Warshower. Suli Kanata Welch. Matthew Winetta. Alexander Laughlin Wesson. Daniel Sean Whiteley. Gregory Silas Whitaker. Michelle Diane Wolf. Lisa Beth Zellman. Gazel Grace Zakria. Reese Kent Williams. John Cole Williams. Donald Bunky Winston. Andrew Thomas Wright. Andrew Yalowitz. Frederick J. Zirkel. Christian Francis DeAndrea. Nathaniel Shelhoff Vistos. Jenise Marie Bordatto. Ian James LaValle. Carla Cherie Hinkle. Wendy Lee Bresnick. Adam Timothy Long. Brian Joseph Pittack.
By the power vested in me by the Fairfax County School Board and the state of Virginia, I hereby pronounce you graduated.
Oh.
May we petition protection and benevolence as we conclude these commencement exercises. Celestial Parent, who orchestrates sunshine and rain, night and day, life and death, grant to these graduates clear vision, determination, and tenacity that they may successfully establish and accomplish their life's goals and become responsible contributors to our society. Bless them with peace and happiness and shield them from destruction. Protect all of us from danger and guide us in helpful ways. Inspire us continually to reach for the very best that lies within ourselves. By protective powers far beyond any we could ever imagine, hold us always. From everlasting to everlasting, may it happen.